Lords of Waterdeep is still one of my go-to worker placement games, especially when I want to introduce that genre to new gamers. It has great art, great components, and one of the best inserts I've seen. But there are some issues with it. Therefore, I question if it should be replaced with a custom insert. Let's find out in this episode of Marty's Musings. Lords of Waterdeep and its expansion, Scoundrels of Skullport, is from Wizards of the Coast and designed by Peter Lee and Rodney Thompson. The game takes place in Waterdeep, the City of Splendors, which is one of the major cities in Dungeons & Dragons campaign Forgotten Realms. In Lords of Waterdeep, you take on the role of one of the Lords of Waterdeep, secret rulers of the city. Through your agents, you recruit adventurers to go on quests on your behalf, earning rewards and increasing your influence over the city. You can expand the city by purchasing new buildings that open up new actions on the board, or hinder or help the other lords by playing intrigue cards to enact your carefully laid plans. Okay, you try to get victory points and the person with the most victory points wins. This game has lots of pieces and bits to it. There are cubes to represent the four different classes of adventurers: priests, warriors, thieves, and mages. Or is it clerics, fighters, rogues, and wizards? There are cubes to represent the four different classes of adventurers: white, red, black, and purple. Plus building tiles, currency tokens, victory point tokens, agent tokens, corruption tokens, building token markers, intrigue cards, quest tokens, and lord cards. So that's a lot of stuff in one box. And to Wizard's credit, they designed what I consider to be one of the best inserts I've ever seen for a game. In fact, I covered it in my first game insert video. Lords of Waterdeep comes in a pretty large box, but it needs to, because inside is a pretty large game board, and then, as I mentioned, a lot of components, with the player cards, all the tokens or meeples for the workers or the agents, the cards here. There's multiple different types of cards, there's scoring tokens, there's a lot going on in this box. But if you look, there is a spot for everything, and this is one of my favorite inserts in a box. One thing I think is unique is just how you get the cards out. If you notice, there's like a heel underneath here that allows you to take the cards and basically push down on one end and then pick them up. And there's a compartment for a couple of the first player token and an additional meeple. Over here, it works the exact same way, another compartment there. You have all your buildings nice in this own little compartment. A slot for everything else, down to the 100 point counter for each of the different colors. All these fit in here nice and snug. They've got the little player markers for each one of those, your money, victory points, and then, like I said, the whales for all the different components that are the workers that are in the game, or agents that are in the game. They're not workers. These are the workers. That's the agents. Don't tell Tony, he'll get me for that. And like other game inserts, I gave it the shake test. Okay, that was somewhat disturbing, but let's see how the original inserts hold up. Whoa, not too good. Looks like we had cards sliding all over the place, all the different kind of cards mixed up together. Yeah, those victory point tokens didn't hold out too well. Now, all these pieces stayed in place. None of these shifted locations and everything, so it looks like it was just the cards. It's not too bad. But it's probably one of those things that you probably don't want to dance around with a lot as you're gaming. Now, since that video, the expansion to Lords of Waterdeep came out and it was called Scoundrels of Skullport. This expansion adds two more small boards with additional locations, additional buildings, lords, and my favorite add-on from the expansion, the corruption mechanic. Like the base game, the expansion has a nice insert for holding all the items, but I would prefer to get all the expansion components into the base box. That's where the broken token comes in, as they have designed an insert for the base game box that holds all the components from the base game plus the expansion. So let's take a look at it. Because of the elongated box, I decided to shoot this with the box on its side so I can get more of the box in frame. So let's take a look. We got the game board here, and it is designed to set in place so it will not slide around. A lot of the broken token inserts are designed like that. One reason is to help keep everything under place underneath it, so they're actually using the board as kind of a lid. Same thing here. Here are the three expansion boards that come with the expansion. They have a little location they set in here like this. And again, now the purpose is to keep these bits from sliding around and falling out. On this side, we've got all the buildings with removable dividers, so you can sort these however you want. Same thing over here, removable dividers for holding all the cards, such as the Lord's card, Intrigue cards, and they're on an incline, so they're easily to pull out. You got all the player pieces set up here. Here is a place for all your adventurers, and there's a compartment for each type of adventurer, as indicated on the bottom. One nice thing about this design is, you might not be able to tell, but there's actually an incline underneath here, so it's like this on the bottom. And the reason why is with these cubes, on a regular box style with a 90-degree angle, these may get hung up in the corner, kind of hard to get out. On an incline, you can easily kind of slide them up and pull them out. So they're very easy to pull out of the compartment. All the wells over here are designed like that. Over here, I've got like place for the money, corruption, and other tokens. So when you're done, put everything back in its own little compartment. Put the expansion boards back, main game board, and you're ready to put it back on the shelf. We saw the original insert didn't hold up particularly well to the disco sounds of the Village People. Let's see how this insert handles some 80s flash. Okay, let's see how it did. Game board's in place. Well, we got a couple building tiles that have shifted out of their spot. We have some tokens that have moved around a little bit, changed compartments. Again, not bad. All the cards stayed in their place. Let's see how the tokens did under these boards. Well, we had a few tokens change locations here. The currency moved from here to here. But it looks like all the cubes pretty much stayed in place. That's really good. With all that shaking and everything that was going on, two expansions in one box and pretty much everything stayed where it's supposed to, I call that a success. I look for custom game inserts that can organize the components of a game in such a manner that makes the game easy to set up and put away. This insert does that, plus it has the added feature of being able to combine the components of the base game and the expansion into one box. That's a huge benefit. Also, it's designed in such a way to help keep all the bits in the places they're supposed to be, even when you're dancing like a maniac. Who wrote that last line? That sounds like something Chaz Marlowe would have written. Like the base game, the expansion has a nice insert. But let's see how this insert handles some 80s flair, flash
from the 80s.
That's good. The other lords by playing intrigue cards to intact your plan carefully.
Oh my gosh, you almost landed on my head.
In fact, I covered it in my first game insert video.
Taz, sit. We need a treat, huh?
Sit. Sit. You're an idiot. Help. Little help. Help.